Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video I will show you how to downgrade macOS Monterey to macOS Catalina on an unsupported Mac. To make macOS Catalina bootable, don't use a USB flash drive but use a Macbook SSD. By using this method, the macOS Catalina installation process will be faster than using a USB flash drive. Okay, let's start this tutorial video. Now open the Safari browser. Then go to google.com. In Google search box type macOS older versions. Then hit enter. On the search results page, click on the how to get old versions of macOS, Apple support link. Now scroll down until you see use Safari to download macOS on your Mac. Now click on the macOS Catalina link. Then it will redirect to the App Store. On the macOS Catalina page, click the Get button. Click the Download button in the pop-up window that appears. Wait for the macOS Catalina download process to complete. The download process for macOS Catalina is complete, then click the Quit button in the pop-up window that appears. Also close the App Store. And the Safari browser is also closed. To make sure macOS Catalina is downloaded successfully, click Launchpad and you will see the install macOS Catalina file. Or can also be checked in the application. Now click Launchpad, click Other, then click Disk Utility. In the Disk Utility window, click View and then click Show All Devices. In the left window of Disk Utility, click on Container Disk 1. In the right window of Disk Utility, click Partition. In Partition window, click Plus icon. Click on the Add Partition button on the pop-up window that appears. On Size, set it to 12 GB. On format, select macOS extended journaled. Now click on apply button. Then click partition, then click on continue. Wait for the partition process to finish. The partition process is complete, then click the done button. Check in disk utility there is untitled volume. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now click on the Finder menu, then click Preferences. In the Finder Preferences window, click the Check on Hard Disk. Now the hard disk partition volume has appeared on the desktop. Click Launchpad again to open terminal. In terminal, type sudo followed by pressing space key. Now open Finder and navigate to Applications. Right click on Install macOS Catalina, then click on Show Package Contents. Open the Contents folder, then open the Resources folder. Drag and drop createinstallmedia to terminal. Then close Finder. Then type --volume. Followed by pressing the space key, drag and drop untitled volume to terminal. Then type --nointeraction. Then hit enter, type the Mac admin password, then hit enter. Wait until the macOS Catalina bootable creation process is complete. The process of creating macOS Catalina bootable is complete. Also check on the desktop that the Untitled volume has now changed to install macOS Catalina. Now close the terminal. Now restart MacBook. In the boot options that appear, select install macOS Catalina and then hit enter. Wait for the loading process to complete. The macOS Catalina loading process is complete. Click on Disk Utility. Then click on Continue. In the Disk Utility window, click View and then click Show All Devices. In the left window of Disk Utility, click on Container Disk 1. And in the right window of Disk Utility, click Erase. Then click Erase. Erase button doesn't work. Now click the Cancel button to close the Erase window. Now click on Disk 1 S2. And in the right window of Disk Utility, click Erase. Then click Erase. After the erase process is complete, click the Done button. Now click again on Container Disk 1. And in the right window of Disk Utility, click Erase. In the name field, type Macintosh HD. Then click Erase. Wait for the erase process to finish. After the erase process is complete, click the Done button. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now click Install macOS. Then click on Continue. In the Install macOS Catalina window, click Continue. In the License Agreement window, click Agree. Then click Agree again. Now select On Disk Macintosh HD. Then click Install. Wait for the macOS Catalina installation process to complete. The macOS Catalina installation process is complete. Now configure macOS Catalina according to your Mac configuration. That's how to downgrade macOS Monterey to macOS Catalina on an unsupported Mac. If this video is useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day ahead. See you in the next video.